Alright, hello guys, how's it going? I literally mean it, how are you doing? Everything's alright, how's your family doing? All good? Alright, good to know. Alright, so there's this cliche that's hanging about in our photo and filmmaking industry, where professionals say your camera gear doesn't matter. I mean, I'm hating to break it to you, mate, it definitely does, 100%. 100%. 100%. I mean, I can do, what's the language? Polish? 100%. 100%. I should have never done that accent. So yes, 100%, it does matter. And if anyone else tells you otherwise, then the chances are they're probably lying. Have you ever actually noticed how typically people with most amount of gear actually complain how your gear doesn't matter? Is it only me? Bit weird in my opinion. You see, without the right gear, you'll never be able to have full creative control over your photos. So for example, if you want a buttery, sizzling, smooth bouquet, you'll definitely need a sharp lens with a lower f-stop, probably something like this. It's a Sigma f1.4, so this can produce amazing bouquet. But guess what, my friend? It ends up costing some money. If you want to film at night or generally in low light condition, you want a camera that can handle better ISO, which ultimately means you're probably gonna have to spend on a brand new body that's probably gonna cost you above £1,000. Oh, what's that? You also want some cinematic pan, zoom and slide? Guess what? You'll need to get all sorts of different slides and gimbals, which again, cost money. Now, do you see where I'm getting at? So A, first of all, forget about the gear, you need the money for it. And secondly, yes, the gear matters. Without say, you can't get those smooth sliding shots or bouquet in your photo and videos. Yes, there might be some hacks telling you how to have a smooth handheld shot, but you can't just produce, for example, bouquet without actually investing into a good lens. Yes, your brand new smartphone, iPhone 11 Max Pro, can probably shoot better photos than, you know, most of the people out there. Heck, I even came from that place. I used to shoot my photos on Galaxy S8. If you scroll all the way down on my Instagram, you'll see all the photos that I shot on Galaxy S8. Fun fact, that's actually the phone that made me interested in photography. Just saying. So yeah, that's my proof. So smartphone cameras can actually do a really good job, but eventually you're gonna have to spend into, you know, a cheap camera body, because that tiny sensor in your smartphone ain't gonna do much justice, mate. Now imagine you're just rocking up to a wedding, even though you're probably gonna have to shoot the entire wedding for free, I don't know, for the sake of experience or something. Now rather than pulling out all of your camera gear, you just pull out your smartphone. Now, you and I do know your smartphone can probably take some good photos, and but by processing them in Lightroom, you can probably get similar results as, I don't know, my camera, Lumix G7 probably. But imagine how skeptical those guys will be, you know, the bride will be like, what the hell are you doing? We hired you, or probably, you know, you're only here, I know, for the experience. But still, you don't have a camera or anything, you're just shooting with your phone. So do you understand what I mean? Camera gear definitely matters. Now hear me out, right? On the flip side of the coin, in my opinion, if you're just starting out, it's better off to start out with whatever you have. Once you start getting into the habit of taking photos, and then and only then, start saving up for something better. Not the best one out there, you know, start saving up for a budget DSLR or mirrorless. I'd say something about £500 to £700. You can probably get better cameras for even £300, but at £500, you can start gently touching the high-end part. And if you start off with a camera that's just about touching the high-end bit, then you're probably gonna have smoother experience moving on to a higher-end setup eventually. So yeah, whatever you have, even a smartphone, secure your fundamentals, you know, start learning about framing, composition, manual mode for goodness sake, and then and only then start thinking of moving to a better setup. Once you're in a better setup, slowly and slowly work your way through the higher end one, and maybe, you know, while you're getting to a higher end one, you're probably getting paid for doing some small gigs, birthday parties, I don't know, some little events, or for shooting cars in dealership. I'm pretty sure your £500 camera can do a stunning job. In fact, here's a recommendation, Lumix G7, £499, you get a body kit lens, amazing to start off with. It's the one I'm filming with right now, 100% recommended. Start off with that one and slowly work your way to the top and probably get like a Sony A7 Mark III eventually, or probably the new Canon R5. I'm actually, you know, kind of like thinking of buying that eventually. I know some people are complaining how it's gonna overheat in that, but you know, I care about the quality, the codec, the resolution, everything on R5 looks stunning. Actually, I'm not even gonna talk about R5 now, but yeah, you get the point. slowly work your way to the top. Also, lastly, I promise I will stop waffling in a minute. In my opinion, using bad care at start can actually be helpful for you. You see, if you spend like, I don't know, 6-7 months on a smartphone camera, you will literally squeeze out everything out of that camera. That means you're probably gonna be better at using shit gear. Now, hold on a second with me. If you are amazing at shooting photos with shit gear, and then you slowly make your transition to, I don't know, Lumix G7, a beginner's camera, you will be 1,000 times better capturing photos, making videos on that camera than if you would have started with Lumix G7. Does that make sense? In my opinion, it's all because you would have practiced by now working with inconvenient gear, working with shit gear, and making the most out of it, that by the time you'll move to something better, you'll know your shit and you will be good from the beginning. And again, you know, once you squeezed everything out of your mid-range camera, you can jump to a high-end one and probably start shooting cinematic sequences like that. You get the point, so I'm just gonna stop speaking now. Just wanna say, guys, I think that's the best time to plug my Instagram right now. That's where I post all of my photography content that I shoot for both YouTube and generally when I go out. All available on Instagram. You know, you can be super cool and follow me there and like my photos and leave comments. And also, if you want to see similar type of content where I talk about photography and filmmaking, probably do cinematic vlog and all sorts of stuff with photography and filmmaking related, then go down below and subscribe. I actually discovered today morning how most of my viewers, in fact 94.3% of my viewers right there, and subscribed, so I don't see the reason why not. You know, you've got this amazing YouTube channel. I know I've only got 310 subscribers, something like that. I don't get it why you aren't subscribing, you know. I kind of upload twice a week for you, but you guys never press the subscribe button. It's not that hard, is it? All right, on that depressing note, I'm going to stop bothering you now. So have a good day. Again, I mean it. Have an amazing day. I shall see you on the next one. Goodbye. Up to us. To change it, no, you would. Wonderful.